Hello, Success Nation. Today I'd like to share with you three tips that we discussed at the RCA Blueprint course this morning. The first tip is the RCA is a team effort. So it's important that you discuss with your practice manager, your educational supervisor, and your receptionist early on. You need to get your practice on board. Because the RCA is a new examination, some of the members of your team might not be aware about the RCA. They might not know what patients that you need for the RCA. So it's very important that you talk with your educational supervisor, you talk with your receptionist, you tell them about the RCA, what cases that would be suitable submit, and what cases that you're looking for. They also need to know what patients that they shouldn't be booking on your clinic list, because these patients might be unsuitable for your RCA. Second tip is to use signposting. Signpost your questions, particularly questions that patients don't expect to be asked. This morning we just had a chat with a trainee who was asking questions to make sure whether the patient does not have Kodiakona syndrome. And the way he asked the question came out very awkward because he did not signpost it. And the patient did not expect to be asked questions about their bottom, about sensation, about lower urinary tract symptom. So it's very important to tell the patient, when somebody presents with lower back pain, there are a few questions I need to go through to make sure that the nerve in your spine is working. So then you ask your question about sensation of the bottom, about bowel control, bladder control. Then patient will be able to know that you're going to ask this question. Tip number three, be genuinely empathic. When you're saying to a patient, I'm sorry to hear that, if you're saying it and you don't mean it, then the examiner will actually pick up on that. The patient will also pick up on that. It's very important that you are congruent when you're saying to a patient, I'm sorry to hear that. It will reflect in your tone of voice and the patient will feel it. So you need to be genuinely empathic if you are saying something to a patient. So mean what you're saying, because if you don't, then it will come on as formulaic. And I've also observed that some people use these phrases excessively. If you're using these phrases repeatedly, then examiners will know that you're just saying it without meaning it. So make sure that you don't repeatedly say some stock phrases and mean what you're saying.
Do you want to take things to the next level and give yourself every chance to pass the RCA? I'm offering a limited one-to-one coaching service where I guide you every step of the way. If you don't want to risk failing the RCA, book for the RCA Blueprint coaching session today, where we can discuss how you can implement strategies, tactics, and tools and receive personal feedback to help you pass the RCA. If you want to join the limited coaching program, click the link down in the description below. If you have any questions or any suggestions, please let me know down in the comment section. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.